Hello, everyone. This is Liam, the extra large leprechaun for miirish.com and live in the pub. I would like to welcome you to today's podcast as originally broadcast on Q90.1 Delta College Public Radio and made possible with the production assistance of the White Crow Conservatory of Music in Saginaw, Michigan. If you enjoy today's podcast, we encourage you to visit our Facebook pages and let us know. Like Live in the Pub, Q90.1 Delta College Public Radio, the White Crow Conservatory of Music, miirish.com, and our podcast sponsors like biddymurphy.com. If you would like to become a podcast sponsor, email us at miirish.com@gmail.com. Now, enjoy your Live in the Pub podcast.
Hello, welcome to Live in the Pub. I'm your host, Zig Zeitler, today, and my co-host, Susan, again, is not with us. She's been busy after the summer winds down. I guess summer's pretty much over, I think, for the most part, but it's kind of winding down here, though. Got the tail end of it here going on, but after that, she'll be back here, I'm sure. But we do have Liam, the extra large leprechaun, is going to be coming in and talking about the schedule, what's going on, and what's happening around Michigan for Irish music, of course. And welcome here to the Dirty Tree Pub. We're having a good time here. A few people are getting a stale stout here. We got a few people getting some tea, you know, a stout and tea, and all kinds of good stuff happens here at the Dirty Tree. Let's see here. We're going to do something a little different today. We're going to feature all fiddle players. You cannot deny the fiddle in Irish music. So we're going to go to one of the... this guy is a staple in Irish music. Keven Burke off the Sweeney's Dream album. Fiddle tunes from County Sligo, Ireland. We're going to listen to Love at the Endings. John MacArthur's Reel, set of tunes there. Number two will be The Humors of Lisdale with Sweeney's Dream. Number three is going to be Murphy's Hornpipe. Number four, The Sligo's Maid, The Woman of the House, and The Sailor's Bonnet. So let's get right on to some good music, okay? Keven Burke. Thank you. All right, that was Keven Burke with Sweeney's Dream. Four cuts off of that. Great stuff. Keven Burke, of course, needed no introduction. He's been around the Irish music scene for a long, long time. Great stuff. Now we're going to move on here. Before I forget, don't forget this is a White Crow production. We're here at the Dirty Tree Pub recording today, and where we always are, and we're having a good time, and we're featuring fiddle players today, Irish fiddle players. I think we might have Swan Scots we might do here also coming up at your way, though. But right now I want to get to my favorite Irish fiddler, my all-time favorite, Martin Hayes. This guy's like, he's like liquid. He's so smooth. I just love to hear Martin Hayes. I've heard him play different times. Several times I met him before, just briefly, but a wonderful, wonderful player. And I must also add that Dennis Cahill, or it's Cahill, I'm not sure exactly which way it's pronounced, but he is the accompanist behind Martin Hayes, and he is flawless. He's just one of the most wonderful guitar players. He has a way of playing, and you hardly notice him being there, but he embellishes what Martin does so well, and you almost forget that he's there, but he's just an incredibly, incredibly great accompanist, and that's one of the hardest things to do, I think, for a guitar player, is just to lay back and accompany and let the, you know, in this case, let the fiddle just do what the fiddle does so wonderfully. And Dennis does some solos once in a while on his own also, but he's a great, great musician in his own right. You can't take that away from him. But, man, what an accompanist. I just love these two together. Wonderful stuff. I can't say enough good about it. I'm going to play Martin Rochford's backed with Green Gown Lass, a couple tunes together. Then we're going to go on to Cora Rowe with Out on the Ocean, another set of tunes. Another set of tunes will be Mary McMahon of Belenahitch, and Miss Lyons. So there's a couple tunes together again, and also Dowd's Number 9 back with Come West Along the Road. So, Martin Hayes with Dennis Cahill. Let's come back. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Martin Hayes with Dennis Cahill. Great stuff. Great stuff. We're going to move along here now. Oh, by the way, that was actually called Live in Seattle, just so you know. And what we're going to go to is some Eileen Ivers with her Wild Blue CD. I played some of this before. Now, Eileen, she does Irish fiddle, but she does some other stuff, too. She gets a little jazzy and a little bluesy sometimes. And it's a nice touch. But we're going to listen to On Horseback, Scatter the Mud, Maldibon Chapel, and Ships Are Sailing. Eileen Ivers and her Wild Blue CD.
Thank you.
looks like I'm going to have to break here in between these couple songs here. Liam came in, and we're going to have to do the schedule now. Let's get Liam doing the schedule, then we'll continue off these other three songs. Come on, Liam, let's hear it.
Well, hello, Zig, and everybody else here on Live in the Pub. It is your good buddy, Liam, the extra large leprechaun, here with the MI Irish calendar of events. I got to tell you, I had a great time last weekend down at the County Oakland Irish Fest, and I hope some of you made it down there and enjoyed yourselves. But you know what? This calendar week, really just about one thing. We'll add a couple extras. But mainly, starting on Thursday, September the 14th, it's the Michigan Irish Music Festival, the 18th annual Michigan Irish Music Festival, of course, in Muskegon. Everybody knows where that's at. Thursday night is the preview night. It runs all the way through Sunday. You can find a link to click on for every day at miirish.com, and then you can click on the calendar. Any of those days will give you a link to their page, or you can simply go to michiganirish.org. Again, that's the whole word, michiganirish.org. You can get the whole schedule, bios on all those people performing. But it starts Thursday, runs Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And without going into great detail on everybody that's there, I just strongly recommend you look for it. If you haven't booked hotel rooms, you probably can't get one unless you stay down closer to Grand Haven or up further north or even east of Muskegon. There's still rooms to be found there, but downtown, no luck. Good luck if you're trying. But we highly recommend that event. It's our favorite every year. I'll be there, but I'll be incognito. You got to kind of look hard to find me. That's the festival. This leprechaun goes simply to enjoy himself. I don't work there. I just have fun there. So check that all out. If you can't make it down there on Friday night, Larry Larson will do his normal gig at the Gaelic League starting at 8 p.m. And we want to point something out, especially on Saturday, September the 16th. A very special show down at the Majestic in Detroit with our good friends, of course, Stone Clover, having a halfway to St. Patrick's Day party. They'll actually be up in Muskegon this weekend on another day. You can check that out on the michiganirish.org. But we think if you can't make it or if you're from the Detroit area and want to have the best time ever, we highly recommend Stone Clover's show at the Majestic on Saturday the 16th at 8 p.m. Sunday, of course, if you're not going to Muskegon, all our radio shows and sessions that are going on. Some of the sessions get canceled because many of the people will be up in Muskegon, so make sure you check your favorite spot. Monday, back to the radio shows next week, and Tuesday, of course, for us. And as long as we're talking the Muskegon Irish Music Fest, let me simply say that right here at the Dirty Tree Pub, preparations are underway for the annual Celtic Caravan from Ragusa here to Muskegon for the Michigan Irish Music Festival this coming weekend. Everyone's meeting Friday morning here for coffee or dirty tea. Then about 10 or 12 vehicles so far, maybe more, will take off across the state making their way to Muskegon for the biggest Irish fest in the state. There's some grumbling already because people are complaining that parts of M20 has pockets of construction that'll hold them up a little bit. And between all the people going, they can't decide where they want to stop for lunch and what time they'll be able to get to their hotels and down to the festival. Some people are going right to the festival and not going to check in till late at night. A few people decided that they're not even going to take part of the caravan, which is an annual tradition, because they want to go Thursday night for the preview night, which has only happened the last couple years. So they're not even going to be in the Celtic Caravan. So all will be forgotten once everybody gets there and the beer's in their hand and they're listening to one of the great bands scheduled at that festival. And we're asking everyone that is going, and I will have mine on, to wear either a Live in the Pub shirt or a Dirty Tree apparel of any kind on Saturday night to show them their colors. And as always, my friends, stay Irish and stay Irish at the Irish Fest.
We certainly will, Liam. Thanks for coming in. Thanks for giving us the schedule. So we're going to move on. Just remember, this is White Crow Production. Like us on Facebook and check out our websites and all that sort of stuff. We're going to go on with some more Eileen Ivers. Continue with some more. I think we left off on Maudabon Chapel, so we're going to hear that right now because Liam came in the middle of that set list. So here we go. Next week, right here, live in the pub.